हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे टॉपिक इज सिस्टम डेवलपमेंट लाइफ साइकिल। द सिस्टम डेवलपमेंट लाइफ साइकिल इज टोटली डिपेंड अपॉन हाउ टू डेवलप द सॉफ्टवेयर एंड देयर लाइफ साइकिल। वेरियस फेजेस आर इंक्लूड। इट इज़ अ कंसेप्चुअल मॉडल। इट इज टोटली डिपेंड अपॉन द कंसेप्चुअल बेस विच इंक्लूड पॉलिसीज एंड प्रोसीजर्स for developing or altering system through their life cycles. Various stages are included in the system development life cycle. System development life cycle is used by analysts. Analyst means which one is analysis, how to system is developed, where the requirement is requirement for the system development. Which the planning also decided by the analyst to develop an information system. In the system development life cycle include the following activity: requirement, system design, implementation, testing, deployment, operation and maintenance. The system development life cycle requirement analysis, system design, requirement analysis, requirement of the system, how and where is the system is required, then system design is decided, then implementation, the implemented, then the testing. In the testing, which is which code is used in the system development life cycle, they tested it, then the deployment and the maintenance. First phase is the phases of the system development life cycle. System development life cycle is a systematic approach which explicitly break down the work into the phases. The system development life cycle, their work is breaks in the various types of the phases, and they are required to implement either new or modified the information system. Their work is breakdown into the various phases. First is the recognition of the need, feasibility study, analysis, design, implementation, post implementation and the maintenance. First phase is the recognition of the need. The recognition means why the system development is needed, why the system is needed, and which disadvantages is shown in the previous system, which needs in the previous system. This is the recognition of the need. Why system is needed? Why system development is needed? It is decided in the recognition of need. The recognition of need leads to the preliminary survey. The recognition of need leads down the preliminary survey. Initial investigation on the current system. The initial investigation is taken on the current system. Which system is working in the organization? The initial investigation is taken on the current system. Determine whether alternative system can solve the problem. And which system is work in the organization? The alternative system can solve the problem. Which problems arises in the organization? If the problem is serious enough, the problem is not handled by the alternative system, management may have an analyst look on. Analyst decided the problem is various serious. How this problem is handled? One must know what the problem is before it can solve. And the problem is arises and how it is handled, this is decided by the analyst. The basis for a candidate system is recognition of a need for improving an information system or procedure. The candidate system is the recognition of need. Why the system is need for improving an information system? For example, supervisor may want to investigate the system flow in purchasing. Bank president has been getting the complaint about the long lines in a drive-in. These types of the problems are arises in the organization and the bank. This needs to lead a preliminary survey or initial investigation. These types of the problems when arises in the organization or anywhere, the preliminary survey is taken on the initial investigation to determine whether an alternative system can solve the problem. Any alternative system can solve the problem. Firstly, the find out the alternative system solve the problem. Then no need to develop the another system. The alternative system solve the problem. Then next is the feasibility study. The feasibility study, depending on the result of the initial investigation. The initial investigation is taken in the first step, recognition of a need. Initial investigation, the survey is expanded to more detail, the feasibility study. The survey is expanded when the initial investigation is completed. The result of the initial investigation is taken, then the survey is expanded. More detail study is taken in the feasibility study. Feasibility study is a test of a system proposal according to its work ability, impact on the organization, and the ability to meet user needs and effective use of the resources. The feasibility study is a test. It's one type the test is taken on the system proposal. Which types of the system proposal is decided by the analyst, and in the system proposal, these types of the function is in the feasibility study. Work ability, which types of the system you made in future, the work ability, impact on the organization, or in organization, which types of the impact is in the future on the organization. Ability to meet user need, which types of the user have need for the these needs are fulfilled in the system. Effective use of the resources, when the in the system proposal, the effective use of the resources, various types of the manpower and the whole organization is effectively use the system. These types of the study is called as feasibility study. The objective of the feasibility study is not to solve the problem but to acquire sense of its scope. The feasibility objective is not solve the totally the problem but acquire the sense of the scope. The scope is found out how the problems is solved. During this study, problem definition is crystallized. Any types of the problem is found in the initial investigation, this problem is crystallized. Accept of the problem to be included in the system are determined. Consequently, cost and benefits are estimated. Cost, many types of the cost and the benefits. The when you decided to decided to develop new system, their cost and the benefits are also estimated with greater accuracy at this stage. The how the greater accuracy is found at this stage, how the accurately the system is made, and at this stage the result of the feasibility study is a formal proposal. This is a simply a report, formal document detailing the nature and the scope of the proposed solution. It consists of the following: statement of the problem, carefully worded statement of the problem that leads to analysis, where the problem is found, which organization, which department is found in your old system. This problem is firstly find out the worded and lead to analysis, summary of the finding and the recommendation as a list of major finding and recommendation of the study. It is ideal for the user who require quick access to the result of the analysis of the system under study. Conclusion are stated. It followed by the list of the recommendation and a justification for them. The summary and the finding, where the problems are finding, the summaries and the recommendation, how to solve their problems. Next, detail of finding and outline of method and procedure undertaken by the existing system, followed by coverage of the objective and procedure of the candidate system. Detail of the finding, the at an outline of the method and procedure undertaken by the existing system, which method and procedure are used in the existing system, followed by the coverage of the objective and procedure for the candidate system and the new system. Included are also discussion of the output report, file structure, cost and benefit of the candidate system. In the existing system, which types of the output of the report, where the problems are arising, their file structure, cost and benefit of the system. These types of the decided in the details of the finding, recommendation and the conclusion. The specific recommendation regarding the candidate system, including personal assignment, cost, project schedule and the target date. In the recommendation and the conclusion, decided the new candidate system the personnel assigned which types of the feature, how the new candidate system is decided, their cost, how many cost is required for the new candidate system, project schedule, how the project is made, their schedule, how their work, which types of the data and their target date, in the which schedule and the target date also decided. Defining the problem, firstly define the problem, scope of the existing system, overview the new system, determine its objective. Firstly defining the problem, where the problems are arrived, scope of the existing in the existing system, the very scope, where the changes is needed is also decided in the feasibility study. Overview the new system is overview is also decided, determine its objective, confirm the project feasibility and produce the project schedule. During this phase, threats, which types of the threats you have arises in future in the software development, in the system development, constraints, integration and security of the system are also included. These types of the constraint, integration and security of the system are also decided in the feasibility study. Feasibility report for the entire project is created at the end of the phase. The feasibility report for the entire project is created at the end of this phase. And the recommendation, conclusion is also decided at this, at the end. Feasibility report is created at the end of this phase. In this phase, the cost, project schedule, their targets, which types of the technical is used, which types of the language is used for the development of the system, these types of the every matter and the everything is decided in the feasibility report and the feasibility study of the system. Next is the analysis. Analysis is a detailed study of the various operation performed by a system and their relationship within and outside of the system. Analysis is a detailed study of the various operation performed by a system. One aspect of the analysis is defining the boundaries of the system. The system boundaries also decided and determining whether or not a candidate system should consider other related system. The candidate system should consider the other related, determine the whether or not a candidate system should consider other related system. During analysis, data are collected on the available files. Decision points, transaction handled by the present system. Transactions are also handled by the present system. Data flow diagram, interviews, on-site observation, questionnaires are also example. For the analysis, data flow diagram, for the taking the interviews of the organization, on-site observation, questionnaires are also these tools are used for the data gathering, for the information gathering from the organization. The interview is a commonly used tool in the analysis. For the analysis, interview is taken the interview of the employee. Which types of the problems are arises in your old and existing system, and in the manually working of the system, which types of the problem, which types of the system you have need in the future for the organization. This is decided by the technique are used, interviews, on-site observation and the questionnaire. Gather analysis and validate the information. Gathering the information, analysis, defining the requirement and prototype for the new system. Defining the requirement, which types of the requirements are for the new system, prototype and the structures also decided of the new system. Evaluate the alternative and the priorities of the requirement. Alternatives, suppose you use the alternative system for the your needs and the requirements. Priority, which priorities need in your system. Examine the information needs of the end user and enhances the system goals. Software requirement specification is a SRS document which specifies the software, hardware, functional, network requirement of the system. It's prepared at the end of this phase. Which types of the software is also need for the development, hardware, functional, network requirement of the system is prepared at the end of this phase. This is the analysis phase. Next is the system design. System design is the most creative and the challenging phase of the system life cycle. Is system design. The term design describes the final system and the process by which it is developed. The most creative and the challenging phase of the system life cycle is the system design. In the system design is the describe the final system, the process by which it is developed. It refers to the technical specification that will be applied in implementing the candidate system. It refers the technical specification that will be applied in the implementing the candidate system. It also includes the construction of program and the program testing. The first step is to determine how the output is to be produced and in what format, which types of the output is produced and the produce in what format. Samples of the output are also presented. Second, input data and the master files have to be designed to meet the requirement of the proposed output. In the system design, the which types of the system design is the most creative and the challenging phase. In the system design, the which systems you decided which requirements you and which problems are arising in the organization in the old system. This is actually in the design, in the system design phase. The first step is to determine how the output is produced and in the what format, which types of the output is determined and the, in the which format. The samples of the output are also presented. Second, input data and the master files have to be designed to meet the requirement of the proposed output. The operational phase are handled through program construction and the testing, including the list of the program needed to meet the system objective and the complete documentation. The operational phase are handled through program construction. The program is constructed and the testing, including the list of the program needed to meet the system objective. Which types of the system objective is decided, requirement, the complete documentation. Finally, detail related to justification of the system and estimate of the impact of the candidate system on the user. Finally, a details related to justification of the system, justify of the system, estimate of the impact on the candidate system on the user and the organization are documented, evaluated by management as a step toward the implementation. Includes design of application, network, databases, user interfaces, system interfaces, design of the application is decided, which types of the network, which types of the database are used, user interface, one form to interface with the other, another form, one department information, how to interface to another interface, system interface is also created in the system design, transform the SRS document in the system requirement specification document into the logical structure which include detail and complete set of the specification that can be implemented in a programming language. Create a contingency, training, maintenance and the operation plan. Review the proposed design. Review the decided the proposed design. Ensure that the final design must be the requirement stated in the SRM document. Requirements stated in the SRS document. SRS document means the system requirement specification document. Which design is decided? Ensure that the final design must meet the requirement of the SRS document. Finally, prepare a design document which will be used during the next phase. Next phase is the implementation. Implement the design into the source code through coding. The coding is decided which languages and which platform is used. These languages code is used for the coding purposes, combine the all the module together in the training environment and detect error and defect. Test report first after the coding, combine all the module and then in the training environment detect the error. Firstly find out this error and then these errors is rectified. The test report which contain error is prepared through test plan that include test related tasks such as test case generation, testing criteria, resource allocation for the testing, integrate the information system into its environment and install the new system. Integrate the information system into its environment. Which types of the information you collected, this information is integrated in the design environment and install the new system. Implementation phase is a less creative than the system design. It is primarily concerned with user training, site preparation and the file conversion. In the implementation phase, they implement the system, install it. When the candidate system is linked to the terminal or the remote site, telecommunication network, test of the network along with the system are also included under the implementation. The candidate system is linked to the, which types of the system you have made is linked to the terminal or the remote site, the telecommunication network, test of the network along with the system are also included under the implementation. During the final testing, user acceptance is tested, followed by user training and followed by the user training. Depending on the nature of the system, extended user training may be required. Conversion usually takes place. Depending on the nature of the system, extensive user training may be required. User training and which users are used this new developed system, they provided the training, how they use the new system, they have problems are arises, the users are provided the training. The conversion usually take place at the about the same time user is being trained or later. Conversion usually take place at the time same time user behave need to training or later. The trainings are needed, the users are provided the training. Which organization is made this software, they provided the training. Next is the maintenance. The maintenance is the most important phase. In the maintenance phase, any necessary enhancement, the user is used the implemented system, they have need to any necessary enhancement, means many necessary changes, the requirement is not fulfilled by the system, they have need to necessary changes, correction changes, it will be they made, make sure that the system continue to work, stay updated to meet the business goals, their business goals, organization goals, they have meet the system or not, they have make the changes, the changes is taken in the maintenance phase. It is necessary to maintain and upgrade the system from time to time and it can adapt to future needs. Necessary maintain and upgrade the system time to time and adapt the future needs. These are the organization future needs. Organization future changes are also taken in the system. The three primary activity involved in the maintenance phase: support the system user, the support system maintenance, system changes and the adjustment. Support the system user and which types of which users are used the system, they support the system user. System maintenance, the many maintenance are also provided by the system. System provided the changes and the adjustment also taken in the system. The organizations are needs to many changes and the adjustment. These adjustments are taken in the maintenance phase. Includes all the activities such as phone support, physical on-site support for user that is required once the system is installing. When the system is installing, such as phone support or the physical on-site support, this size of the is used in the system. Implement the changes that software might undergo over a period of time. Implement the many changes of the software might undergo over a period of time. Many changes is taken when the many time period is undergo. Then many changes are taken in the software. Implement any requirement after the software is deployed at the customer location. Customer's location is facing the problem for the software. The new requirement is deployed in the software. It also includes handling the residual error, resolve any residual errors are handling, not any application or not any data is not provided properly, any types of the residual error, resolve any issue may exist in the system, any types of the issues or the problems are arises even after the testing phase. In the testing phase also many errors are occurs and many problems are occur. This also resolve in the system. Maintenance and support may be needed for a longer time for a large system. For the large system, in the many users and the huge operations are performing, then maintenance and supports are also provided for a short time for a smaller system. For a short time for the smaller system have provided for the short time the maintenance, but on the large system, longer times the maintenance are needed. After the installation phase is completed, the user staff is adjusted to the changes created by the candidate system. Evaluation and the maintenance begin. After the installation phase is completed and the user staff is adjusted to the changes created by the candidate system, then evaluation and the maintenance is beginning. The user staff is totally adjusted with the new system, then evaluation and the maintenance is begin. Like any system, there is aging means is the process is being older. Aging means the process is being older that requires the periodic maintenance of the hardware and software. The hardware and software also periodic means 6 months, 1 year, the maintenance is necessary. If the new information is inconsistent of the design specification, the changes have to be made. The any information is not added in the new system in the design specification, the changes have been made in the existing system. Hardware also require periodic maintenance, the 2 months, 6 months, annually. The maintenance is also provided to keep it tuned with the design specification. The hardware is also adjust with the design specification. They work properly with the software. The importance of the maintenance is to continue bring a new system standard. The new system standards are also provided by the maintenance. This is there is the close here session. Thank you.